वेलकम टू ई लेक्चर सीरीज फॉर बीटेक फोर्स एम सब्जेक्ट डाटा कम्युनिकेशन एंड कंप्यूटर नेटवर्क्स। माय सेल्फ प्रकाश मीना, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट, इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज अजमेर। सो वी विल गो टू अवर टूडेज टॉपिक। हियर इज द टॉपिक, डिस्टेंस फैक्टर राउटिंग। अर्लियर वी कवर्ड फ्लडिंग एंड शॉर्टेस्ट पास। सो टूडेज टॉपिक इज डिस्टेंस फैक्टर राउटिंग। So computer networks generally use dynamic routing algorithms that are more complex than flooding and but more efficient because they find shortest path for the current topology. There are two dynamic algorithms, first distance vector routing and second link state routing. So here we will discuss about distance vector routing algorithm. So a distance vector routing algorithm operates by having each router maintain a table such as a vector, giving the best known distance to each destination and which link to use to get there. And these tables are updated by exchanging information with the neighbors, and every router knows the best link to reach each destination. Distance vector routing algorithm is sometimes called by other names also, like the distributed Bellman-Ford routing algorithm, and it was the original ARPANET routing algorithm and was also used in the internet under the name RIAP, RIP. In distance vector routing, each router maintains a routing table indexed by and containing one entry for each router in the network. This entry has two parts, the preferred outgoing line to use for that destination and an estimate of the distance to that destination, and the distance might be measured as the number of hops or using another metric, and as already we discussed in shortest path, and router is assumed to know the distance to each of the its neighbors. If the matrix is hop, the distance is just one hop. If the matrix is propagation delay, the router can measure it directly with special echo packets that the receiver just timestamps and send back as fast it can. An example is assume that delay is used as a metric and that the router knows the delay to each of its neighbors. Once every t millisecond, each router sends to each neighbor a list of its estimated delay to each destination. It also receives a similar list from each neighbors. And imagine that one of these tables has just come in from neighbor X, with X being X estimate of how long it takes to get to router I. If the router knows that the delay to X is m millisecond, it also knows that it can reach router I via x in xi plus m milliseconds. By performing this calculation for each neighbor, a router can find out which estimate seems the best and use that estimate and the corresponding link to link in its new routing table. And note that here old routing table is not used in the calculation. So the updating process is illustrated here in figure, you can see here. And here part A shows a network, and the first four column of part B shows the delay vectors received from the neighbors of router J. So A claims to have a 12 millisecond delay to B, a 25 millisecond delay to C, a 40 millisecond delay to D, and etc. And suppose that J has measured or estimates its delay to its neighbor A, I, H, and K as 8, 10, 12, and 6 milliseconds respectively. So consider how J components its new route to router G. It knows that it can get to A in 8 milliseconds, and furthermore A claims to be able to get to G in 80 milliseconds. So J knows it can count on a delay of 26 milliseconds to G. If it forwards packet bounds for G to A, Similarly, it computes the delay to G via I, H and K as 41, 31 plus 10 and 18, so 6 plus 12 and 37, 31 plus 6 millisecond respectively. The best of these values is 18, so it makes an entry in its routing table that the delay to G is 18 milliseconds and that the route to use is via H, and the same calculation is performed for all the other destinations with the new routing tables shown in the last column of the figure. So here you can see the last column, new routing table for J. The count to infinity problem. So the settlement of routes to best path across a network is called convergence, and distance vector routing is useful as a simple technique by which routers can collectively compute shortest path, but it has a serious drawback in practice, and although it converges to the correct answer, it may do so slowly, and in particular it reacts rapidly to good news but leisurely to bad news. And consider a router whose best route to estimate X is long. If on the next exchange neighbor A suddenly reports a short delay to X, the router just switches over to using the line to A to send traffic to X. In one vector exchange, the good news is processed. And so how the fast good news propagates, so consider the 5 node linear networks as in figure here, and where the delay metric is the number of hops. So suppose A is down initially, and all the other routers know this. In other words, they have all recorded the delay to A as infinity. So you can see here, and then when A comes up, the other routers learn about it via the vector exchange for simplicity, and we will assume that there is a gigantic gong somewhere that is struck periodically to initiate a vector exchange to all routers simultaneously. At the time of the first exchange, B learns that its left hand neighbor has zero delay to A, and B now makes an entry to its in its routing table indicating that A is one hop away to the left, and all the other routers still think that A is down. At this point, the routing table entries for A are shown as in the second row of figure here B, figure B. So on the next exchange, C learns that B has a path of length 1 to A, so it updates its routing table to indicate a path of length 2, but D and E do not hear the good news and until later, and clearly the good news is spreading at the rate of one hop by one hop per exchange. In a network whose longest path is of length n hops, within n exchanges everyone will know about newly revived link and routers. So now let's consider the situation for figure B, in which all the links and routers are initially up, and router B, C, D, E have distances to A of 1, 2, 3 and 4 hops respectively, and suddenly either A goes down or the link between A and B is cut. So there is the problem, and at the first packet exchange, B does not hear anything from A, and C says, "Do not worry, I have a path to A of length 2 and then little does B suspect that C's path runs through B itself, and for all B knows, C might have 10 links with separate path to A of length 2. As a result, B thinks it can reach A via C with a path length of 3, and D and E do not update their entries for A on the first exchange. So on the second exchange, C notices that each of its neighbors claims to have a path to A of length 3. It picks one of them at random and makes it new distance to A 4. So you can see here in figure 4, and subsequent exchanges produces the other distances. Here you can see in figure B, and from this figure it should be clear why bad news travels slowly. No routers ever has a value more than one higher than the minimum of all its neighbors, and gradually all routers work their way up to infinity. But the number of exchanges required depends on the numerical value used for infinity, and for this reason it is wise to set infinity to be the longest path plus 1. And this problem is known as the count to infinity problem, and there have been many attempts to solve it. For example, preventing routers from advertising their best path back to the neighbors from which they heard them with the split origin, with poisoned reverse rules already discussed in RFC 1058, and none of these heuristics works well in practice despite the colorful names. And the core of the problem is that when X tells Y that it has a path somewhere, Y has no way of knowing whether it itself is on the path. So that is the count to infinity problem. So now the session is ended here, and all the matters and details are from Computer Networks 5th edition, and you can refer this book for more information about Sylvester's vector and other routing algorithms also. So thank you.